Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this matchup between the Broncos and the 49ers. AFC versus NFC as kickoff fast approaches, Phil.
Well, we have two teams that don't know each other very well. And when you don't know each other very well, you play cautious. And when you play cautious, you don't play as well as you should. So it should be a high-scoring game.
Got the hand up into the sky, and that means fair catch.
He's trying to move it to the bomber, don't you?
The Broncos go with two tight ends on this play. Now first and 10. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Holy, we've got an injured player on the field.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
Dreesen's in the slot here for this play. First and 10. The defense gets the sack.
There's nothing worse early in the football game to get sacked by the defense if you're a quarterback. Now you sit there and go, is this going to happen all day long? Does it change the process how you play? Do you get rid of the football quicker? A lot of things go through a quarterback's mind.
Too much pressure, and he's brought down again.
You got to be smart on the defensive side now here, third and long. Be a little careful. Maybe give up a short pass or a short run, and if they throw it short, make sure you come up and make the tackle.
I think when Coach Box, as we look back at him again, when he first took the job, he had to be excited about what he saw on that defensive side. Before he knew he was going to get Peyton, he knew he had the likes of Von Miller on that defense and others.
They got good players on the defensive side. They have speed, Jim. You know, they have a good offensive line, too. So I think the makings of a solid football team were there when John Fox became the head football coach of the Denver Broncos. And then after 1 year, I think Peyton Manning goes, wow, I like what I see in Denver. A very good offensive line. When you have a good offensive line, that gives the quarterback a chance.
Fair catch this time. LaMichael James is in the backfield. First and 10. And James has got the handoff on the counter. And they bring it down at the 44-yard line.
The defense cannot give up these long runs. You have to hustle to the ball. Get a lot of people around the ball carriers to make sure they don't take short gains and turn them into long ones.
I run that shit again, dog.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. They better hurry to get the snap. Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. Always aware of the chains. He's got the catch, and he's got the first.
Well, they call this route a lot of things. They call it a go route, a nine route, or a fly route. And all of them mean the same thing. Run as fast as you can to get behind the defense.
First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
That's where, man. The
well, they're teaching all these guys in the NFL, don't hit high, and we might be seeing more of this. Lower body injuries because the defensive players, they're learning. Hit them lower. Don't get any flags thrown at them.
Second down and 10, middle.
21 yards. Colin Kaepernick has one of the biggest arms in the NFL and is definitely one of the most explosive quarterbacks when it comes to running the football. That was a nice job of keeping it and picking up some good yards.
Gore's got it on the toss.
Good job by the defense that time. Everybody's expecting a pass. They were ready for the run, and they stopped the offense for a short gain in the red zone.
Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has an injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a 49ers official. LaMichael James's injury seems to be relatively minor, or at least it's minor enough that he'll be back on the field shortly.
The Broncos with a nickel look here on defense.
As much as these guys practice during the offseason, training camp, during the week, you think receivers and quarterbacks would always be on the same page. That time they were not, and it's another incomplete pass.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Third and goal at the four. And he's going to pitch it here.
Going to be a tackle for a loss.
Run the shit on me, homie.
That's
just bad
execution by the offense. Bad decision by the quarterback. He pitches it out to the running back. Nowhere for the running back to go. And he lost a couple yards on the run.
Fourth and goal to go. Trying the right side.
Oh, stop you.
Finally, the defense stood up. It's fourth down. They've given up a long drive, but they come through in the clutch that time. Nice job.
Boy, I see more sitting than it is, man.
Welker's in the slot. First down at 10. It's over to Welker. Incompletion.
Come on,
that
man. You're going back way too much.
The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Second and 10. Looking to the right side and throwing. Brings it into his body. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
When you see zone defenses, throw it into the open spaces. That's what the quarterback did that time. Good job by the receiver running in there and making the catch.
Welker is going to get set in the slot for this snap. First down, throwing again. Under fire on that throw. Welker's a receiver in the slot. Manning's got it in the gun. He'll throw it over the middle. Just had to avoid the sack. The quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. The Broncos get a first down on his way. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20.
Jim, what a nice throw by the quarterback. Puts the football right in the hands of the wide receiver. He's behind the defense, but look at the hustle and the speed by the defense. They get the tackle from behind.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Unable to bring it in.
All you have to do is watch the head of the receiver. When they drop footballs, usually it's because you can see their head move the other way before the football gets there. That's what happened this time, and it's a drop pass.
Welker's lined up in the slot on second and 10. Throws the pass, and it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
That's why you like defenders who are good punishing tacklers. Make those receivers worry about coming over the middle. They'll be careful the rest of this game because of that big hit.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. Broncos in the end
end zone. What a tough throw and catch rough, into a tight spot right there for the touchdown. But today's game, these players are so good that you have to throw it in traffic. They've got to make the catch. That time he did.
The Broncos for the point after. And the point after is good. Matt Prater is ready to run up and kick this football. Tackled at the 13.
That's a good one.
The defense comes out in the
Ohio,
nickel.
Ohio.
First and 10. Kaepernick able to find Mario Manningham.
Nowadays, it's getting harder and harder to play this tight man-to-man coverage because you're not even allowed to touch these superstar wide receivers.
Ohio. Here we go.
Second down, 3 for the first. Slips right through his fingertips.
Do one thing at a time. Catch the football, then do the next thing. Run with it. He tried to run with it too quick. That's why he dropped it.
Ohio!
LaMichael James is in the backfield. Kaepernick from the gun. Catch made by Mario Manningham.
Well, it doesn't look like much, but it really serves the purpose. Picks up the first down, and now they have a chance to open things up.
Ohio!
James out in the slot. First and 10. They tackle him for a loss.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. That wraps up the first quarter here in San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the second. The 49ers offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. Second down following the run. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. No one's going to get him now. And they bring him down at the 33-yard line.
Well, when you try to tackle this guy, his legs are the size of a refrigerator, so hard to wrap him up. That's why he picked up the big game.
He sends the halfback in motion.
Let's roll!
First and 10. LaMichael James gets the carry. Right side. And that's a gain of maybe 5.
When you have a defense as fast as this one, they over-pursue. So that's why you want to run a counter run. Take advantage of the fact that they are just charging too fast, too hard, and not thinking on the defensive side.
Going across the middle, makes the grab, and keeps the ball moving down the field. That's a first down catch. The offense picks up another first down and extends this drive.
They are, Jim. They're marching down the field, and I give all the credit to the offensive line. They are dominating the defense right now.
Kaepernick's going to take it from the gun. He'll fire it out to the left.
Oh, come on, man.
This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
Kaepernick standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap.
He had no time to get set.
I'm going to go for Chavez next.
Nickel formation here for the defense. Third and 10. Getting away from the pressure. Ball is out.
Yep.
And
what
did
I say?
Recovery is made by the
what
defense.
Did I say? Go, boy.
That brings the play to an end. Great job by the defense, forcing and recovering the fumble.
You said the appropriate word there, forcing. The hit was so solid and so good. The offensive player had no choice. He had to give up the football.
Thomas lined up now as a slot receiver.
First and 10.
Looking across the middle, under pressure, and incomplete.
I guess my offensive line can't block you now, especially right there.
Moreno lined up in the backfield. Second and 10. Throws to the right. Reaches out and grabs it.
Good job by the play caller that time. Calling for the short pass. Even though it comes up short of the first down, it opens up many things that you can do on third. You can run a reverse, draw plays, screen plays, or if you want, you can still throw it down the field.
Third and 2. The quarterback will hand it off. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Very few teams in the league can do this and run the football for first downs. Anytime it's in a situation, third and 2, third and 3, they don't even think about run because they're not tough enough to get it done. They have to throw it. Nice job by this offense.
Welker's in the slot. First and 10. And he's taken down.
This defense is awesome. And let's see. That time they blitz, they get the sack on the quarterback. They time the snap count perfectly and catch the offense by surprise.
It's over to Welker. The reception.
Yep.
Easy. Wide open.
Way.
Touchdown.
Oh,
someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
They're flagged for running into the kicker. Broncos ready to boot it down the field. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now. Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Broncos team official. Welker's injury doesn't appear to be anything too serious. Yes, he'll be sore tomorrow, guys, but that's not going to stop him from returning today.
First and 10, heaving it down the field. Hauls it in deep down the middle.
Oh, my fault. That's all right. I'll give that to you.
Touchdown.
This
game is tight.
You got to celebrate that, though.
Good job by the offensive coordinator calling those plays. Leads to a touchdown. They're just slowly chipping away at this lead. Now can the defense come out and help them out?
Homie, that was mass coverage. I had no questions about this.
The Broncos back deep
ready
to
receive. Longer.
He'll have a chance to take off. gets to about the 36. It's first down as they head to the line. Here's the handoff and they'll run it.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
Speaking of Coach Fox, we met with him, as we always do, on Friday, and it's almost, after a while, it's hard to get him to leave the room. He'll stay all afternoon and talk football with you.
Well, I don't know if he talks football. John Fox has a great way of saying a lot of things when you get done. What did he tell you? Well, there's not much. So there's a quality in a head coach doing those type of things. Loves to talk about golf, everything. Just a good person, and I think that's why the players love him. He knows how to handle people. That's probably his greatest asset.
The offense needs 10 yards here on third down after that last completion. Third down and 10. Looking for an open receiver on the right. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Well, it's a nice throw by the quarterback that time to get just enough yards to pick up the first down.
Moreno's lined up in a single back formation. Looking to go up top again on first down, and he's forced to the ground.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Split backfield here. Deep, looking for Demaryius Thomas.
Why are you
and no
out of
one
bounds,
is going to catch this
man?
One as it goes out of bounds.
I fucking play so stupid.
Welker is going to get set in the slot for this snap. Challenging the defenders to the right side, and Wes Welker holds it in.
Well, this defense, cover four, where four defensive backs are back there deep. It stops all the big passes down the field. But look at these crossing routes. Wide open, hit them, and let them catch it, run, and you still get the big play.
Here's the first snap after the big play. They're going back up top. They're going to get him here for a sack.
Not a good job by the quarterback that time. Inside of 2 minutes in the first half, you got to get rid of the football. If nobody's open, just throw it away. That time, he loses yards by taking the sack.
Defense comes to the line, ready to pounce on that quarterback one more time. Can they get another sack right here? Peyton Manning from the shotgun, eyeing that left side, brings it in. They bring him to the turf.
Boy, they got a good drive going here, Jim. I guess you don't hear that too much on the golf course, too, the way you hit it everywhere. But this offense, they're clicking. They're making plays. Let's see if they can take advantage of just moving this football down the field.
Manning from the gun, looking to the right side and throwing. Inhales the pass.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense. And now they have a good situation.
So they complete that one, yet it's still second down. They'll go shotgun here. He's looking to the right here on this throw. The 49ers signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. This drive now about to reach the 10th play of the series. Catch is made, and it's
going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
The kick is good.
Never take it for granted. When you're trying a field goal, a lot of things can go wrong, but good execution that time by the offense and a good kick. 3 points.
Their catch signal. And Crabtree's a receiver in the slot. First and 10. Taking it right up the middle. Has some space to work with. The 49ers now move the chains. So that's going to do it for the first half. Broncos are up in this one. We're back here now in this one where the Broncos lead by 10. Danielle Bellini is there with the latest from the sidelines.
I got a chance to quickly speak with Colin Kaepernick during halftime. Right now, his guys are trailing, but he told me he wasn't concerned at this point. He said, we haven't played our best football, but that's okay because we can still finish strong and get this win. That's it from down here, guys. We'll just have to see how things play out. Back up to you.
Thanks, Danielle. And now we'll go to the field. Now in first down. Running back in motion here. Second half gets rolling now as he takes the snap. Gains 17.
I like this. Show some patience. Don't try to get it all one play. Pick up first downs and try to go down the field and score.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. Now first and 10. He'll throw it over the middle. Hauls it in for the first down.
Jim, they call that a post route. You know why? Of course you don't know why.
Oh, see, our inbounds got open. Blocking back covers, man.
Post, so they call it a post route.
We shouldn't even be that open. Not even close, man.
This play set up by the long gainer. Halfback sent in motion. Kaepernick's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Looking to scramble.
What?
Trying to work that left side.
Incomplete
as that ball sails out of bounds.
Ohio! Ohio!
What did she say?
Wide receivers stacked up on this play.
What are you doing now, man?
Second and 10.
You're not listening?
Looking for a receiver on the left side here.
How do you stop these receivers?
That's
almost impossible with the rules of the game.
How receivers catch the ball? They get hit and they fumble.
That time they have double
coverage
on him.
It doesn't
matter.
The throw comes.
They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, we did our best.
Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. Throwing now to his left. Gaines, 19.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
Gore now makes the move to the right. Touchdown and drawing close.
That is a nice touchdown there. You chip it away at that lead. Try to get into the minds of the opponent. Will they get tight? Choke? Yeah, I think they could be choking over there on the other side. Look out.
The ball is out. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. Will run this one back. Gets out past the 30 and brought down at the 35. Yeah.
pass is lined up in the slot. That pass was hers. Moreno lined up in the backfield, throws the pass on the spot.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top
on,
and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
Manning's going to throw once again on this down. The throw to the left.
Intercepted. Oh, this fucking dude.
Nice tackle.
Oh, man.
They are so talented. They can just do everything. They're strong enough to stop the run. How about this interception? Good job. Good reading of the quarterback and a nice catch.
Nickel formation for the defense here. First and 10, and he's thrown to the ground.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see. They don't have to blitz, and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
Second and long. Kaepernick able to find Mario Manningham.
That time the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Bavaro, a very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Now in rhythm, the quarterback drops back to throw once more. And the quarterback is taken down.
Well, every defense is looking for somebody to sack the quarterback. And that time, the speed of the defensive end gets around the tackle and gets the sack.
There is a flag out. Incompletion on that hurried throw.
Offside. Defense.
Oh, okay. All right.
Well, looks like the defender was caught in the neutral zone, Phil.
Yeah, he was. Good job by the quarterback. You know, he made that little voice inflection. That'll get him every time. The quarterback's a little sneaky, you know.
Colin Kaepernick under center. Second down and 12. And it's thrown incomplete.
In these type of situations, when you lose the game, it's third and long. Don't try to be a hero, because when you try to be a hero, it's going to lead to a turnover. Then you really will be in trouble.
The 49ers at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. On third and 12. Throws a strike.
The best way to keep the other offense on the sidelines is just keep marching down the field and picking up those first downs. What a good job by the offense.
First down here after the completion. And they tackle him down at the 37-yard line. Colin Kaepernick will be taking this one from the gun. Taking it up the middle. The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Third and 10. Incompletion, forcing it into double coverage.
I think this is one of the easier throws in the NFL. Don't make the mistake throwing it up the field. Throw it across the field so the receiver can run to it. That time the quarterback leads the receiver way too far on the post route.
Colin Kaepernick under center. Trying to make something happen.
Well, they don't get it on fourth down. That was a quick drive, wasn't it, Jim? That was just bad play calling. bad execution and go to the sideline. That's where you deserve to be.
First down, offense readying for the snap. Tosses it to the running back. And he's going to be tackled right around the 43.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets him a few yards.
Quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a sixth time in this game. On second and three, handoff. The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Nothing fancy about that, but it's a good run, gets a first down. Now the offense has three more chances.
Welker's lined up now as a slot receiver. First and 10. They'll stay on the ground on first down. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
That wraps up the third quarter here in one of the world's greatest cities, San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the fourth. Welker's in the slot. For the start of the fourth quarter. Gets it again here.
And this defense, they are tough. When you run that football, they got some men up front. And that time they stopped that run just for a short gain.
Split backfield here. Down at 12. Going across the middle, incomplete, almost intercepted.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
Moreno lined up in the backfield. To the right, has the first down.
Nice job by the coach that time going forward on fourth down. His team is up here in the second half. He wants to keep momentum on his side. That's why he goes for it, and they get it.
They've got a first down now after that catch. First and 10, Moreno's going to take the handoff now.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Are you serious? Oh, shit. I got 4 minutes left in this game, babe. Dang. Why don't you just tell Julio to come pick me up? All right, well, hold on then.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Second and 9, looks to his left.
makes the catch in the open field. Finds the sacred sod. Touchdown.
Well, when the offense goes in there and scores again to increase their lead, it's got to give a lot of confidence to the defense. Now can they go out there and do their job?
It's good.
Offside. Defense.
That's what happens when you try to guess the snap count. Matt Prater is ready to run up and kick this football. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
Did you? Oh, yeah.
Frank Gold is in the backfield, working that left side. Almost intercepted.
Oh, come on.
Too much pressure on the quarterback
right
on that play, Phil.
That defense, boy, oh, boy, are they aggressive, and they can get after the quarterback. We saw it on that play. This is going to be a tough assignment for this offensive line today.
Second down and 10. He's got room. And he's brought to the ground.
You're going to win the game like that, dude. You only got 3:40 to go.
The defense comes out of the nickel. That'll put them in what we call plus territory. Well, Jim, I always say it's about deception when you're playing offense. That time, the play action fake by the quarterback was so good, the defense didn't even see that he still had the football. He throws it down there for a nice
catch.
Another first down by the offense. The defense is definitely getting fatigued. And when you get fatigued, you cannot think, so look out. Let's see how they back up the big play here. Getting sacked.
This might not be nice to see, but every once in a while it's kind of fun to watch the quarterback get sacked like that. Good job by the defensive end.
This is a screen play all the way. Fights through that hit. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
This quarterback should have never thrown this time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple yards.
Flex round! Flex round!
Play number six coming up on this drive. There's some shifting around in the backfield. Play clock's running down. Pass is made, and it's incomplete. The hit jars the ball out.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. From the shotgun. This is going to set up a change of possession.
And the crowd is always yelling. Their team is losing. Go for it. It's fourth down. Well, they went for it. Now what do you say? They didn't get it. Bad call by the offense. They shouldn't have done it.
Two tight ends, takes the knee. San Francisco. We'll go with the extra tonnage here, with the jumbo set. Second and 12. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Defense calls a timeout.
Well, Jim, they didn't pull the defense at all. Second down, you run the football, hoping to make it third and short. Then you lose yards, third and longs. They're hard to get in the NFL.
36 minutes.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up. Setting up screen. The tackle is made, and that's a three and out series for the offense.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long. They can do just about anything, and it's going to work. And they stop the offense that time.
The punt team is in place and ready to perform. He's going to challenge the punt coverage. Gain of 8. To the line, and it's first down. Frank Gore gets it here. They deck him in the backfield.
Hey,
when you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
And Crabtree is going to get set in the slot for this snap. Drives ahead. Breaks free. Has some space to work with. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. First down and 10. Looking across the middle, Kaepernick hits Crabtree with that pass.
When you talk about the play-action pass game, it's really when you call it. You got to be in a situation where the defense is thinking run, and when they are, do you have the courage, or I should say the smarts, to fake the run and throw the football? Good call that time by the offense.
Down inside the red zone now, trying to score as quickly as possible.
And listen, the defense has got to know the situation here. It's okay to give up a few yards, maybe give up a completion. Just don't give them the big play that gets the quick score.
Touchdown. That'll close the gap. What a spectacular performance that was with the touchdown by Kaepernick here in the late going.
It sure was. I saw him in college many times at Nevada, and he was always coming through late in the game in the clutch and getting it done, and he has continued that trend with the San Francisco 49.
The 49ers are at the line, and they are out of timeouts. So they get the touchdown, but they go for two and fail to convert.
I'll be the first to say it. That was a terrible decision to go for the 2 points. I'll give the defense some credit, but mainly the blame goes to the offensive play call.
And he is tackled down at the 38-yard line. First down here. Takes a knee. There's a flag out.
Offside. Defense.
Players for both sides made an appeal, but the referees say it's on the defense. The quarterback got the defense to commit, and it looks like it'll cost him 5.
Encroachment. Defense. Still first down.
First down here. This was a good game to watch today.